Dr. Subramaniam Swamy and President of the Janata Party of the NDA, Seshadri Chari of the BJP National Executive Member are debating tonight with Khushbu DMK leader. And my first question is to Dr. Naganathan, who's founder of youth.org, a group which is vehemently against this visit. How he's visiting privately is not a state visit. You can put your points very clearly, then I want a response. You must give equal time to the other side. You know, you can't create trouble. He's not visiting Tamil Nadu. It's a non-political visit. He is here to lay a foundation stone for the construction of a center for Buddhist studies. I mean, what's the argument here?
Tamil Nadu has passed a very strong resolution representing all political parties that Rajapaksa should be declared as a war criminal. And we need an independent international wartime investigations over Sri Lanka, which has not been done yet. And Rajapaksa has not answered about killing of 600 Indian fishermen, not yet. Rajapaksa has not answered the Indo-Lankan Accord of 1987, giving legitimate rights to Tamils. With all these activities on the pipeline, you are inviting Rajapaksa for a non-state visit. So inviting a war criminal, whether it's a non-state visit or not, is immaterial. When the world is mounting across for an human rights investigation monitored by UN, and when there is an LLRCRE recommendation should be done where India voted against Sri Lanka in UNHRC.
Yeah, go on.
So it is must for us to oppose this type of stand.
Subramaniam Swamy.
This type of stand.
Subramaniam Swamy.
Is a clever politician.
No, no. Complete your point.
Yeah, BJP is, Rajapaksa has sensed that BJP is going to be the next state of power. He's playing cards.
Oh.
So yes, attain credible relationship with BJP right now in the process that he will cover up his war crimes when the regiment changeovers in India.
Subramaniam Swamy is smiling. I don't know why. I'd let him respond to you. Dr. Swamy. Why do you find what Dr. Naganathan is saying so amusing? Does he not represent the majority opinion among a lot of Tamil people?
We are Indians first and Tamils afterwards. And where there is a clash of Indian interests and Tamil interests, the Indian interest shall prevail. Now, those who want to come and make trouble, they will be arrested and put in jail and allowed to cool their heels there for some time there. But that's about all. They can protest for all I care. But the fact of the matter is that Rajapaksa did India a great favor by eliminating the LTT, which was a national security threat for us. And therefore, we consider him as a friendly neighbor, as a president of a friendly country. And he's welcome any time, official or non-official visit. And a few handful of Tamils cannot decide these things. And I also think that your own channel should stop using words like pro-Tamil parties of Tamil Nadu. There is no such thing as a pro-Tamil party in Tamil Nadu. There's only either you are a pro-Indian or anti-Indian. There's no other category.
One second.
About Indian interest, what's the answer for 600 Indian fishermen being killed by the Sri Lankan army? Why does Rajapaksa doesn't pay heed to any type of Indian solution for ethnic problems for Tamils? Why did Sri Lanka always has an opposite stand during Indo-China war?
The answer is in the recent local bodies election in Sri Lanka, where the Tamils have voted overwhelmingly for Rajapaksa's party, rejecting the TNA, which is supposed to represent Tamil interests. So I think the answer is given there very clearly. So who are these people to talk about Tamil interests when the Indian government is supposed to look after all citizens? There cannot be a sectional view on these matters.
Now, what happened to the federal solution offered? The Rajapaksa government has rejected any type of federal solution by the unitary constitution passing over by the Supreme Court.
Okay.
What happened to the Indo-Lankan Accord?
I'd like to get in the two other panelists also, please. This is getting to be an interesting fight between you and Subramaniam Swamy. and you're presenting very different points of view. I'm enjoying it as well. But let's ask the BJP if they have any consistency in their view before I come to Khushbu and see whether the DMK has any consistency in theirs. Mr. Seshadri Chari, tell me, I'm just curious. Because it is Shivraj Chauhan, BJP Chief Minister, who's going to be hosting him. Which way did the BJP vote? What was the BJP's position during the anti-Sri Lanka UN resolution that censured the nation over its human rights record? I presume you were with the nation when India voted in favor of the anti-Sri Lanka UN resolution. Weren't you, Mr. Chari?
No, as far as the UN resolution was concerned, as a party, we had a very different view. Our view was that India should not have voted in favor of the resolution, but at the same time, we should have impressed upon the Colombo to be more realistic towards their solution, towards finding a peaceful and amicable solution to the Tamil issue. And the Colombo is already, Sri Lankan government is already seized of the matter, and they are doing a lot of good work. And they have also realized the potential danger of alienating the Tamil population in Sri Lanka to such an extent that it gives rise to players like the LTTE, which has grown much beyond their control. But as far as this voting on this resolution was concerned, we tried to impress upon the government.
Are you for or against?
Mr. Chari, you are usually
very clear. Today I find a slight internal confusion. Is it because a very senior BJP leader herself extended this invitation as the senior Congress leader and Union Shipping Minister G.K. Vasan seemed to indicate recently? Is that the reason for your confusion? I mean, what is your position? Do you want Rajapakse to come or not to come for this event? Do you think it's going to hurt any Tamil sentiment?
Anyone who reads the Constitution of India would know that external affairs, army, defense and currency are all the prerogative of the Union government. However much I may like Rajapakse, I cannot go to Sri Lanka and invite him to come to our country, and on my invitation he cannot come. It's a private visit. It's an absolute personal visit. And n number of leaders have gone to Sri Lanka.
Private visit.
Spoken to Rajapakse. He has also
private visit.
So
Dr. Naganathan
of India, APJ Abdul Kalam, went all the way to Colombo, and Abdul Kalam also extended an invitation to Rajapakse to come to India.
Private visit argument. One second, Khushbu doesn't buy the private visit argument. Let's get Khushbu in. You don't buy the private visit argument. Go ahead, Khushbu.
And
one second. Let's get Khushbu.
Incidentally, Mr. Karunanidhi has himself said.
Really? What has he said?
Incidentally, Mr. Karunanidhi has also said that opposing Rajapakse's visit will not solve the problems. So I see it as a very positive development in Tamil Nadu also.
I think Mr. Seshadri gets to get it very clearly where the chief has said, we do not welcome the visit of Mr. Rajapakse. First, let us make it very clear, Tamil Nadu is part of India. Okay, Tamilians are Indians. I agree with Dr. Subramaniam on the point that it's not about pro-Tamilian or anti-Tamilians. It's about pro-Indian. And Tamil Nadu is a part of India. So I think we need to work as it's a simple, single country. So Tamilians being killed is Indians being killed. So let's get it very clear. Let's not push Tamil Nadu out of the map of India. It's not. It's part of India. So when Indians are being killed, I think we need to stand together. BJP is welcoming the stand because BJP is hosting them. So I think you need to understand BJP are on one side. It gives a very tall claims that they are working for the people of the country. So why are they pushing Tamil Nadu alone? Why are they pushing Tamil Nadu away? Why are they pushing Tamil Nadu?
Why are you avoiding taking
India?
A position on
we
Rajapakse?
Are part of India.
Why are you avoiding taking a position
yes,
on Rajapakse?
We are
May I remind you what the WikiLeaks cables revealed about Rajapakse's role in the alleged massacres of Tamil civilians and the captured LTTE fighters? The cable had also said, the WikiLeaks cable had said at the point of time, that the responsibility for many of the alleged crimes rests with the country's senior civilian and military leadership, including President Rajapakse, his brothers and General Fonseca. I want you to take a position tonight. Why are you avoiding taking a position just because he's going to Madhya Pradesh? Where do you stand, Khushbu? Is your party sure of where it stands?
Of course, my party is very clear as to where it stands. We are absolutely clear. We have not said that we are welcoming Mr. Rajapakse's visit, whether it's private or whether it's political. I think when a political leader of Mr. Rajapakse's stance comes to India, you cannot say it's just a private visit. Then why are we discussing?
So what's your position tonight? Enunciate your position clearly tonight. What's the DMK's position?
We are very clear. DMK is very clear that we do not accept Mr. Rajapakse's stand coming to India. Yes, it's an issue between the two countries.
You can't.
We need to solve the issues. Like, one sec, let me finish, Arnab.
I thought the DMK is part of the central government.
The chief had said.
The DMK is part of the central government, and therefore you're in a tangle.
Yes, it is. Yes, no, we are not in a tangle. We have always been clear in giving a very clear views whether it is, which is in with
the itinerary.
With the coalition of the
itinerary,
UPA
the itinerary
or not.
Has been
I think
finalized.
We need to get a clear stand.
Khushbu.
No, we need to make it clear, Arnab, but let me finish first. Let me complete.
Arnab, I want to respond to that.
Let her complete. Dr. Naginathan, I will come to you. Let her complete.
Let's make it very clear. When the tourists were attacked in Tamil Nadu, the Sri Lankan tourists were attacked, we condemned the attack. We said this is not the right way. When the players were sent back, the football players were sent back, we condemned it. We said let's keep it separate. Political scenario between the two countries is different. Let's not bring in religion, let's not bring tourism, let's not bring in sports into it. But I think Mr. Rajapakse coming to India is an issue not as a Tamilian but as Indian. I think we all need to understand that
yes,
Tamilians
but,
are Indians
certainly,
also.
Certainly,
we need to understand. We
but,
have no.
But
we
if it is
it
an issue,
clear. I think.
But if it is an issue, which by your own definition it is, Khushbu, then it is an issue which has taken place because, as Sushma Swaraj says, the itinerary of Mr. Rajapakse has been set up by the PMO and the Ministry of External Affairs of the central government, of which you are an unbreakable part. So, Dr. Naganathan has a follow-up question for you now. Dr. Naganathan has a question for you, Khushbu. Go ahead.
Yeah. Not for Khushbu. I want to answer the BJP spokesperson who has been here.
Oh, go on.
See, he said that any external affairs should be the purview of the central government. But I would say that they couldn't pass a TISA agreement bypassing Mamata Banerjee regarding Bangladesh. Mm-hmm.